Coming up on the show today, more Tom versus Time, plus Nike and Kaepernick in business together. All right, so apparently Tom Brady will come up with the epilogue of his Tom versus Time series on Wednesday. So it's basically like a 5-minute episode to wrap up the series. And I will be totally honest with you, I do not understand the motivation for Tom Brady to put out this documentary. I don't get it. All it does to me is create more buzz, more chatter, more noise about him. And it also feels like as he's gotten older and dealt with more and more, he doesn't want more attention on him. So I have no idea why he's so into putting out this kind of content. I mean, if he was upset and wanted a place to vent, he'd be better off writing in a diary or just saving up his thoughts and writing a book later. I don't know how a documentary available to the public puts him in a better place. But we'll all watch the epilogue, critique it, and react to it. Also, Adam Schefter, appearing on an Adrian Wojnarowski podcast, reiterated the fact that there were a lot of people within the Patriots organization that were disappointed to see Jimmy Garoppolo traded. Here's my take on that situation. It's been my take this whole time, and I'm very confident in the take. At one point, Bill Belichick got the message to Adam Schefter directly that he had no interest and no intention in trading Jimmy G. That's why Schefter expressed that sentiment with such conviction on WEEI a year or so ago. That is also why I believe Robert Kraft intervened and totally changed the course of Bill Belichick's intended action. Belichick had no intention of trading Jimmy G. The rug was pulled up from under him and he was forced to make a deal. That's what happened. I guess Bill could have played two quarterbacks if he wanted. Nick Saban's doing it. Here's what's most surprising about how Nick Saban is handling his quarterbacks. And it became more clear after that interview debacle with Maria Taylor over the weekend. Saban is just afraid to hurt Jalen Hurts' feelings. The media's not trying to get you to disrespect one of them. Tua Tagovailoa is a better quarterback. Your other guy, Jalen Hurts, isn't as good of a quarterback. So you know what that traditionally means in football? The better quarterback plays and the not as good quarterback is the backup. You're playing two quarterbacks. That's outside the norm. So people, media, people interested in what you're doing are going to ask questions. And the fact that you won't make Tua the full-time starter because he's clearly better says to me that you just don't want to hurt Jalen Hurts' feelings. And the only reason he can get away with it is because Alabama's so good and it's college football and they can still win games playing two quarterbacks. And obviously the bombshell from over the weekend, Nike premiering its ads featuring Colin Kaepernick. Do I have a problem with Nike using Kaepernick to promote its products? No, I don't. It's not going to make me buy Nike stuff. It's not going to make me not buy Nike stuff. If they want to use him, that's their right. Just like it's Kaepernick's right to engage in a peaceful protest. Nike will alienate a lot of people by doing this, but Nike, one of the best, most successful companies in America, clearly did its research, and they must be okay with putting at risk or losing out on a lot of that Make America Great Again money. Colin Kaepernick did reportedly have other opportunities to play in the NFL, and if that was the case, the whole tagline of sacrifice everything would be technically incorrect. I'm not a big fan of a blatant inaccuracy if that's the case, but in terms of using Colin Kaepernick as a spokesman for their company, that's fine with me, and they appear prepared to deal with the consequences of that decision. All right, take a pick. Which opening day Patriots loss stung more, the 2001 opener in Cincy when they lost to the Bengals, or when they got destroyed by the Bills in Buffalo to start the 2003 season? In 01, you were coming off of a 5-11 season. Then you lose to Cincinnati, who was never good. Now, Drew Bledsoe didn't look bad in that game, threw for 241 yards, 2 touchdowns. The Patriots defense gave up around 150 yards on the ground. Thought the team was gonna suck again. I think Lauri Malloy hurt his neck in that game. But the loss that stung more was 03, when Malloy, just after getting released, goes to Buffalo, then helps former Patriots quarterback Drew Bledsoe crush their former team. 31-0. You have no idea where the season's gonna go from there. People are saying that all the players hate the head coach. You hadn't really seen a Tom Brady-led team get blown out like that. Malloy sacked Brady, and they had won the one Super Bowl, but then they went 9-7, so you weren't sure they were going to be the team that they ended up being. I would say overall, the 03 season opener stung more. All right, my lock of the day. I'm taking the A's at home tonight, +1.5 over the Yankees. The A's are one of the best teams in the American League. They're probably going to the playoffs. I think Oakland avoids losing that game at home by more than a run. That's my lock of the day. Have a good one.
Well, as you know, I'm not on Snapface and all that, so I don't really get those.